everyone, welcome back to my channel, Conversations with Sunflower. Today the videos may seem a little backwards. I'm gonna do a part one and part two of this video. Actually, the first part I'm gonna be talking about my experience traveling on an airplane with my son Majesty. The second part of this video will be what I typically pack for my son. And I know it's a little backwards, but I had a few moms request that I would start this video off with my traveling experience. I have a few points that I noted on my phone, so if you see me looking down, that's what I'm doing. First things first that I want to point out, if you're traveling with a child, I think it's either 3 years younger or 5 years or younger, you get to board the plane first, which is a good thing because you're able to get on the plane before anybody else and get settled, get your child settled, and then that ensures that you get to put your carry-ons above in the cubby above your seat. So that's a good thing. I really love that. They're gonna call you, they're gonna tell you, mothers, fathers who are traveling with children at a certain age can go ahead and board the plane. Everybody waits for you. You get at least like 10-15 minutes to get situated. So that was pretty dope. I didn't want to bring a stroller because at the time I didn't have a small umbrella stroller. We have like this ginormous stroller that connected to his car seat. So I didn't want to travel with that. I didn't want to even check it in. So what I did was I had a baby carrier and I just strapped Majesty into the baby carrier, and that way I was hands-free with anything, especially going through TSA. If you have your baby strapped onto you, they're going to pull you to the side and check you separately than what you usually go through if you're walking through by yourself without your baby. Heads up, they are, if you are formula feeding and even if you pre-pump breast milk, they're going to check your baby's milk to make sure there's no alcohol in it. Like, people would do that, but anyways, they're gonna check that. And getting back to the baby carrier, I have the, what is it called, an infantino or something like that carrier. It's like a 5-in-1 carrier. You can carry your baby on your front, the back, whatever, put them up high, put them up low. But it was just easier for me because I was able to keep my hands onto my carry-on, my handbags and everything like that. It was easier for me to make sure that I'm able to lift my bags up into the cubby and such like that. It's very breezy in Sacramento today, so. Woo! I didn't need his car seat on the plane. This was our first time traveling, well, my son's first time traveling on a plane, and we were visiting Sacramento, California. At the time, we were living in North Carolina, so my mother-in-law had already purchased a car seat for him, so I didn't have to bring it and check it in or bring it on the plane. I know I've heard some stories where mothers bringing their car seat actually on the plane. I don't have any experience with that. Excuse me, y'all. And you may hear my son in the background. We're in our backyard. But yeah, I didn't bring the car seat whatsoever. We didn't pay for a separate seat for Majesty. Majesty sat in my lap the entire time of the flight to California. We had two layovers, and I believe the first flight was like 2 to 3 hours and the second flight was 5 hours, and he did really good. If you breastfeed, I suggest you get prepared to nurse throughout for a good amount of time. I know all babies are different, but I noticed with Majesty, with me nursing him, it calmed him down, and I didn't even really have to nurse him through takeoff and landing. He was pretty calm. He was sitting and I was talking to him and making sure he was comfortable. It was when we were actually up in the air where he was fidgety and didn't want to sit still. So I would just nurse him and he actually would sleep throughout the entire flight up until landing. And now that I think about it, I didn't even really have to feed him his snacks. Like, I packed snacks for him, and he just really wanted to nurse the whole time, and he slept. Let's see. Oh, very important. I do not suggest getting a seat in the back of the plane, especially like the last seat. I think in one of the flights, I had to sit, I had a last seat on one of the flights, and it was very uncomfortable. You can adjust the seats back there, and you can't lean back and stuff like that, and it's just very uncomfortable. You want to make sure you're either sitting in the middle of the plane or towards the front of the plane or the very front of the plane, so that way you are able to adjust your seat forward or backwards so that you and your child is comfortable. I also suggest sitting, not getting a window seat or a middle seat when you're traveling with your son or a daughter, because it's very uncomfortable, especially if you do not have a family member sitting by you. If you have a family member sitting by you, that's fine, because they wouldn't mind your child stretching out over them. But if you're by yourself with your child, you want to sit in an aisle seat, because it's just comfortable for your baby to stretch out. And most of the time, if they're like my son, if they're sleeping throughout the entire flight, then you don't want to be by a window seat anyway, because they're not looking out the window. They're sleeping, and you would want to probably catch some Z's too. So the aisle seat was just comfortable for me, as far as maneuvering my son, getting him comfortable. And also, it's an easy access to the bathroom when you have to change baby or you have to use the bathroom. You don't have to worry about climbing over folks and all of that. So here are my tips. If I miss anything, if you have any questions, you can comment below, or you can follow my social media. I'll have that in the description below. My son is climbing under the chair. Talk to you guys later in part two of my video, so stay tuned. One love. Blessings all about my life, and I thank God for the day.